University of San Francisco, Business 305, Principles of Finance, Team 1, Take 1, in action.
Hi guys, my name is Eliana Berger, I'm the project lead. This is Simran, my financial analyst, and Naomi, my marketing analyst. We're going to present to you our JP Morgan valuation report. In this situation, our recommendation is to sell, as the intrinsic value is lower than the current price of 88.4. So the background on JP Morgan, ticker symbol is JPM. They're a public banking and financial services firm. They were founded by none other than JP Morgan in New York in 1799. So for their operating segment, they do consumer and community banking, corporate and investment banking, commercial banking, and asset management. Altogether, their net operating income is $95.7 billion. They do a variety of products and services, tons of stuff, I'm not going to list all of it. It includes private banking, which is different than our Goldman Sachs thing last week. So that includes like credit cards and ATM services, as well as their investment services, which are treasury, asset management, etc.
So next we have the senior executive leadership at JP Morgan, which includes James Diamond, Stacey Friedman, Ashley Bacon, Marianne Lake, John L. Donnelly, Matthew E. Zames, who have all been there for a minimum of 4 years. Next is the organizational chart. This is an organizational diagram of JP Morgan. As you can see, it's a taller structure that lead down to the four different operating segments, and then down further to the different, split up by the different products and services.
For the company ranking, as you can see, here's the latest. The first one, JP Morgan Chase, which is $2.4 trillion for total assets. For the slot, the first, like the strengths, they have strong brand names and good financial position. Weaknesses, they have like the over dependence on USA, the opportunities to expand in other countries, and the last one, threats, they have changing government regulations and financial crisis like recession.
Okay, so for the financial condition, we compared JP Morgan with Goldman Sachs and their peer group, which is Citibank, Wells Fargo, and Bank of America, using their profitability ratios, ROA, ROE, profit margin, and leverage ratios, debt to equity, and financial leverage. Their overall ranking was good.
So next we have the financial condition continued of JP Morgan, Goldman Sachs compared to Bank of America, Wells Fargo, and Citigroup. We looked at the different equity ratios and growth rates. To give us the conditions listed on the right-hand side, which give us an overall condition of average. Next is the technical analysis. Long-term, it's looking at an upward slope. However, the short and intermediate term is looking downward. There is a resistance at $93 and support at $87. This is the two-year
So for the perpetuity model, we took the intrinsic value, which equals next year's cash flows. We used 2018, divided by our three interest rates. So we have the WACC, the S&P 500, and the CAPM. We used the S&P 500 9% as our median at 75.3.
For the golden growth model, after we calculate the stock value is 84.8 and is smaller than the current price, and it's at 4.3%.
Next, we have the multiple approach model, where our median stock value, we got 81.4, which is a discount of 8.7% from our current price of 88.4. Next, we have the DCF model valuation, and our median range was 82.3, which is a 7.5% discount from the current price of 88.4.
So altogether, we weighted them to ensure accuracy. We got 81.6 as our intrinsic weighted value. We recommend to sell this stock. You should not hold it. You should not buy it. You should write forwards, write futures, write calls on futures, and buy puts on futures for your indexes. And then for your ETFs and stocks, sell stock, sell short, write calls, and buy puts. And these are our references.